Well, hi there, everybody, and good Thursday morning to meteorologist Travis Klineski here. Looking like another chilly day for many of us here, although western Nebraska, you're going to see a warmer day today. There's a band of cloud cover making its way eastward from north central Nebraska to the southeast part of the state, and part of south central Nebraska also included in that. There's even been a few flurries or some light snowfall within that, and it's not out of the question we see that for parts of the day, that we see that little bit of a light snow or flurries from about Ainsworth to Hebron on eastward. As we go through the day, though, we'll see decreasing clouds in central Nebraska, lots of sunshine out west, but those clouds will be very important to the forecast. The longer they hang on, the colder you're going to be today. So eastern Nebraska, cold, chilly in the middle, cool but better out towards the west, and again, touch on the breezy side with those south and southeast winds, 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, well, we're going to drop back into the teens and 20s, but mostly clear skies, so it'll actually be a decent night out there for this time of the year, pretty close to average for this time of the year. And as a warm front comes through, we may actually even see temperatures rise a little bit towards sunrise tomorrow morning. Now, your Friday starts off sunny. We'll see a nice warm-up take place for your Friday, but clouds will increase in the afternoon, so temps will start to kind of slow up with their warming by the afternoon hours. And in fact, by the end of the day, there about 6 o'clock, just before sunset, we will start to see precipitation enter the picture, some light rain or snow out west. And the way things are playing out, it looks like the brunt of our precipitation will come overnight Friday night and early on Saturday morning, and still some lingering chances Saturday during the daytime morning hours. But it looks like the real accumulating snowfall may even hold off till Sunday, but only out to the southwest. Let's explain this to you. And I've looked at several forecast models, and most are keeping the brunt of the precipitation to the southwest. This goes through Saturday evening at 6 o'clock here. And again, you're not seeing much for precipitation. I'm not saying we won't see anything. It's just that this is the European model. It's not showing much, and most forecast models are not showing much for most of us. But if we do see something, again, the farther southwest you go, the better chances. But after Saturday night, we actually could start to see some accumulating snowfall with, again, the higher totals to the southwest. So while there still are some questions to take place here with the forecast for this upcoming weekend when it comes to the snow chances, it does favor the southwest portions of the viewing area for the best chance of seeing the higher snowfall amounts. How much those will be, there's still some question marks with that, but this is one of the forecast models showing higher amounts. So for most of us, I don't think there are going to be major impacts out of the snowfall over the weekend. Now for today, mostly cloudy skies up north, maybe becoming partly cloudy later. Some early light snow is possible, low to mid 20s to lower 30s for highs. In the west, much warmer conditions, upper 30s to lower 50s, partly to mostly sunny skies for today. To the south, we're looking at temps ranging from the mid-20s to around 40 degrees, partly to mostly cloudy, again, decreasing clouds. And to the east, even a few flurries or light snowflakes possible, and mainly or mostly cloudy skies. We may see a little bit of late-day sunshine, but only low to mid-20s this afternoon. To your extended forecast, well, it gets a little better for tomorrow, but it is temporary. And then here comes that chance of precipitation. We'll cool it down on Saturday. Sunday, a very cold day out there. Highs only in the teens. We recover into the upper 20s on Monday. A better day for Tuesday into the 40s, but it will be on the windy side before we fall off on Wednesday. And just looking at the long-range trends here, it does look like maybe another shot of colder air coming towards the last couple of days of February there. So we change from February to March that following weekend. So those last few days of next week will likely trend colder. And then farther down the road, I'm hoping that we start to break out of this cold a little bit. If you look back through the last couple of months here, we've been in three-week cycles, 3 weeks of colder than average, 3 weeks above average, 3 weeks colder than average, and back and forth. Well, we're about halfway through this colder spell now, so I'm hoping that, you know, by the time we get towards early March, we'll start to move back into the warmer side of things. So we'll wait and see on that. And, you know, it's still several weeks away yet, but hoping to trend that way. So again, the big concerns over the weekend, watching that chance of snow, most of us not significant impacts. Of course, that can still change. We're still 2 days out, so that could change. But I think the farther southwest you go, the more impact you'll see out of this next upcoming storm system. So there's your forecast for today. Until next time, I'm meteorologist Travis Klineski. Hope you have a great Thursday.